This is a story about three different fairs in three different states that all had the same problem. The Southern California Fair in California, the Clark County Fair in Washington, and the Arizona State Fair in Arizona all had an empty space. In Washington, it was an outdoor area near a covered food court. In California, it was a new commercial vendor's tent. And in Arizona, it was an old home arts building. The first step is always the same. It's to orient the stage floor to best suit the location. The stage can be set up at three different heights, 20 inches, 8 inches, and floor level. And of course, we can also set it up at custom heights when the need arises. Second, we build the frame. The basic size is 12 feet wide by 8 feet deep, and it's 10 feet high when the stage is at floor level. There are additional wing pieces that make the theater 25 feet wide, and a 4x8 thrust stage can be added to the front. Finally, we put on the drapes. They're made of an outdoor fabric designed to allow maximum airflow and promote ventilation, but it is not intended for outdoor use in the rain. After all, it is the FairTime Theater. Let's see if we can tell the difference the FairTime Theater made with our before and after comparison. Clark County Fair before and after. This is the theater closed up for the night, and here it is open in the morning. Southern California Fair before and after. We set up before the commercial booths were even installed. Arizona State Fair, before and after. We turned the entire end of that building into an attraction. Each fair had its own set of goals for their areas. The Clark County Fair needed a stage for the smaller community acts and paid acts at the food court tent near the carnival area, and they needed someone to run it. The FairTime Theater is a great showplace for community acts, solo performers, duets, trios. Even a quartet can find it a comfortable performance space. And paid acts appreciate a stage designed as a theater that provides a shady place to play any time of day and on into the night. The Southern California Fair was more business-minded. They needed an attraction that would take care of itself, help build attendance in the commercial tent, but not distract from the sales and services being offered there. We started by finishing our installation before the vendors moved in order to minimize any inconvenience. We also varied our performances by alternating lecture presentations of magic lessons and gambling demonstrations with stage shows such as the Think Safety Magic Show for school tours, the juggling and unicycle mastery of Chaz Marquette, and the family comedy magic of Frank Thurston. Now that's a show that always drew a great crowd. In the evening, Eric DeLue presented his thought-provoking Magic of the Mind. The Arizona State Fair hosts many school tours during its 21-day run, and they needed a show in one of the older buildings near the Children's Carnival to entertain these young students. We produced the Rainbow Magic Show, a special educational show designed to teach numbers and colors with a puppet clown performing magic shows for the younger children, and the show was available in either English or Spanish. Three different fairs with three different needs in three different states, but all those needs were met by the FairTime Theater. But wait, there's more. The FairTime Theater was specially designed to help you sell it to your sponsors. It provides a headline banner area, two upright banners, 60 square feet of sides, and a main drape that's 6x8. For one sponsor or several, there are many places they can be featured. If you would like to experience the magic of the FairTime Theater at your event, contact us for a free consultation.